The Gemara, Maseches Bava Kama, Yuhu, Bava Kama, Lamed Aleph Amud Aleph, with a mask on my face. Lamed Aleph Amud Aleph says, the Gemara, we are now learning about the Dilu Nishmas of Imoir, Menachem, and Akiva, Rus, Bas Sholem, Saul, Bas Moshe, Lofuas Rivka, Bas Yehudis, Lofuas, Pninachar, Bas Gil, Rochel, Yehudis, Bas Rivka, Golda Gil, Bas Shifa, this year, I'll tell you exactly, Be'ezras Hashem, the outline of today's shiur. Today's shiur can be very hard, can be very easy. Depends how you take it. If you listen, and you listen to every step separately, you dissect it, each section by itself, Be'ezras Hashem will be easy. The beginning, at the beginning of the shiur, Amar Rove, we're going to see a statement of Rova. That statement can be interpreted in two different ways. And the Gemara is going to basically jump between explaining it one way or the other way. Okay? That's the main thing. We have to know Rava's statement by heart. We have to know exactly the words of Rava. And then once we know Rava's statement very well, the words of the statement, even without understanding everything about it, everything will be very easy in Mirtzah Hashem. I just want to give a quick introduction to save us a lot of time. This is like a little bit of a test on what we've been learning so far. You tell me, please, according to Chachomim, Rabbi Yehuda, that group, if a person bumped into something mistakenly, something that was placed by someone else, and then he broke his dishes, broke the kelim, and the water spilled, is he chayev or not, and why not? Yes or no, and if no, then why no? Ah, nitkal. We say posher or onus, machloikis. Chachamim believe nitkal, a person who bumped into something, unless it was very negligent, we say it's onus, it's beyond his control. People just trip sometimes, they collide into things. Can't take it anymore, I'm sorry. Yeah. Now, what happens afterwards? If he doesn't pick up his pieces, doesn't pick up his belongings on time, what would they say at that point? No, according to Rabbi Chachamim, is not chayev. That's Rabbi Meir. We're not Rabbi Meir now. Why is he not chayev? Because a mafkir the nezek, mafkir nezokov potu, a person actually disowned, relinquished authority over his ownership, over his objects that are hefker, because this is something broken and garbage. Therefore, he is potter of what happens later. Again, it's not nice. It's groma, bidei shamayim, but he's potter. That's Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbanon's opinion, and that is the accepted opinion, not Davka. We're not holding that this is how we paskin, but this is what we're going with in the next few lines. Secondly, as it hits the ground, as it's breaking, we assume is mafkir, unless we know otherwise. So there's no one moment, as explained to you many times, in Muki Yosef, there's no one moment when you can say is chayev. Now, that's about kelim. What would you say about a person? We said yesterday, what happens if a person falls and it's not his fault? Yeah, fell without it being his fault. He's not to be blamed because he's a nitkal. Boom, takala. Yeah, mishap. And then the person himself did not actually get up on time. He likes it there on the grass. He has an excuse not to continue his work day. He fell. It was an accident, but now he's actually enjoying sitting in the grass an extra 5-10 minutes with excuse that, you know, he was so traumatized by the fall and other people bump into him and he did not inform anybody about his fall. He's not warning. He's not shouting, hey, he's not doing anything to stop it. What do we say then? Chayev. Why? Because the person is not, you know, should have warned. And also because should have done something to Bidiuk, he overstayed his welcome, and therefore we can't say about a person, as the Muki Yosef says, he's mafkir himself. By the object, he also overstayed the welcome of your objects, but then you can say, it's not mine anymore. I'm disconnected from it. But when you talk about him, when you talk about he himself, a person is not mafkir his own body. You belong to yourself, right? Secondly, we're not even sure called the bow. Maybe called Odom Amazik. Odom Amazik is always chayev. Secondly, so you're okay, so far so good. Another introduction, very easy. A bow in the street, regular bow in the street, which you chayev on. What are you chayv on? Let's say somebody bumped into your bowl or fell into your bowl with his china dishes on his shoulder, whatever. The person was injured and the china dishes were broken. What are you chayv for? No. No, so not nothing, because we established that a person that's injured, you are chayv. A person who died, you're not chayv, because we don't pay for dead people. Doesn't look nice. It's not nice to pay for dead. That's kilu, you're selling your life. You're paying for life. Mashenken, a person who's injured, you chayv on, by the bor. Kalim, no way, ever. Kalim that break, you never chayv. Kalim that break, that get stained, like, let's say, garments, you are potter in bow. Shav v'loy odom chamo v'lo kelim. Yeah, the Torah says, shav v'chamo, donkey and ox, excluding a person who died and excluding kelim who died, meaning broke. So now, that person that sits on the floor, boom, he sits on the floor and he overstays his welcome. There are two ways to look at him. You can either say that this person is an odom hamazik, he's a person who's damaging others. Instead of actively punching them in the face, what does he do? He passively punches them in the face. He sits there, knowing very well other people may come, and he says, I don't care about other people. And then what happens? He's like Adam Amazik. If you view him as Adam Amazik, he's chayv on everything. You tell me, guys, please, you've been through Bava Kamma long enough. A person that breaks kalim, or breaks the nose of someone, or breaks the nose of the donkey, or kills, is there any difference which item or person did the person damage? Yes or no? If a person actually punch somebody, makes a difference? Somebody, someone, animal, kelim? Huh? And therefore is chayv on everyone. Beautiful, Yitzchok got the 10 points. A person, there's no difference. There's no tomun, there's no odom, kelim. A person's chayv on everything. So if this person, I'm now bringing about the question which we ignored yesterday on purpose. When the person sits on the ground, I like sitting in the street. Well, people bump into me, I don't care. Or his tam is being negligent, then how do you classify his nezek? On one hand, he's a human being. He's a heilig neshume. He's a human being. On the other hand, he behaves like a bow. If you say that this person is an odom amazik, then like my esteemed colleague said, he's chayv on everything. He's amazing. And by the way, a person's chayv even is not amazing. Even without amazing, the person onus, right? The person who sits there and knows, even if he's not intending to hurt anybody, but he's just being negligent, as long, yeah, even honest, we said, Odom od loylum is chayv on everything. Now, Mashenken, if you view that person as a bull, and then someone bumped into him with his kelim, then he'd be chayv only on the person damaged, but he will not be chayv on the kelim that bumped into him and broke, because he's a bull. That's going to be, we're not in North Korea, we're even before that, we didn't begin to the shear yet. So again, if the person is looked at as a person, mazik, is chayv on everything, anything that bumped into him in the crash accident, mashenken, if you view him as a bow, because he's static, he's not active, he's behaving like a bow, meaning he's a static nezik, and bow is static, then we say, only an odom that was hurt is chayv. But if Kalim bumped into him, a person with his dishes bumped into him and fell, he is potu like a bow. And that's going to be the question today. One of the questions we're going to deal with is, how do you view that person who is a sitting, he's not a sitting duck actually, a sitting duck is a sitting target, it's the other way, he's making everyone else sitting ducks. Yeah? He's a sitting nezik. Is he bow and potter and Kalim, or is he odom and he's chayv on everything? Yes, sir. Yes, me lord. Right. We finished the introductions. Listen carefully and read carefully Rova's statement. Remember what we said yesterday? There was a crash accident of what? There was like a chain accident, as we call it in Hebrew. One after the other, after the other, the three people. Reuven was Nitkal. What was Reuven Nitkal? I don't know. Something that nobody put there. The wind put there. Somebody, yeah, Reuven was nitkal in a log of wood, a stump of wood that the wind just brought there, you know, but whatever, fell from the sky. Now, the first one bumped, then the second one bumped into him, and the third one bumped into him. Omer Reuven, we said all of them are chayv. Listen carefully. Rishon, chayv nizke sheni. Ben Minizke Gufa, Ben Minizke Mamoina. The first one is Chayv on the Nezikim of the second one, whether it's his Guf or his money. You know what the problem is? Before we even continue, before we even start, the word his is a very esoteric, enigmatic word. What do we mean when we say his Guf and his money? Do we mean to say that the first person, Chayev, whether he's the damager or the damagee, is the first one Chayev, a nezek caused by his body, caused by his mom? Or does he mean to say that he's Chayev on things that he did to the second person body and to the second person's mom? I'm leaving that alone for now. I'm just reading the words translating to English as if I'm a robot translator. I'm reading again. I'm over it. The first one is Chayev Nizikim, and the second one, Ben Benizke Gufo, Ben Benizke Mamoino. Whether he damaged Guf or Ben Nizokim of the Mamni, of the moment, the money, the objects. Shani, on the other hand, Chai Benizke Shlishi, Benizke Gufo, Avalo Benizke Mamoino. The second one is Chai. Okay, the second guy bumps into him, and what happens then? Then he's chayev on both goof, and yeah, he's chayev also on thing caused by his money, by his mamon. Okay, you get me? In other words, the first guy lying on the floor, him and his broken object, the first guy. The second guy bumped into them, so then the first guy is chayev both whether the second guy bumped into his body of the first guy or the first guy's objects. The first guy and his objects are both looked at as mezikim. Now the second guy, though, if a third guy boom bumped into the second guy, how? And he bumped into the second guy's body, his chayev, but the second guy's kelim, if he bumped into the second guy's dishes and the second guy's potter. To make it very, very simple, the first guy's body and the second guy's body are both looked at as mazikim. Mashaken, when it comes to their broken dishes, imagine yourself a cartoon in your mind. The first guy has a whole load of broken dishes. The second guy, a whole load of broken dishes. And now the first guy's broken dishes are considered as mazik. And if they bump into them, he's chayev. The second guy's broken dishes, if somebody bumped into the second guy's broken dishes, then he is potu. The second guy's potu. Now you may ask, I'll repeat. Okay, we'll repeat anyway soon, but Frag the Gemara, justice for all, American. What's the difference? And justice for all. Mimanafshach, Frag the Heilige Gemara, penultimate line. What's his story here? What's his discrimination? Is that the color of his skin? What's going on here? Init kal poshehu. Remember Mechlokes Rabbi Meir Rabbi Yehuda, which we said about 10 times? If you're Rabbi Meir Nik, chumre, and you think anybody that bumped into anything is a poshea and has to pay, shenina milchayev. If you say the bumping is what? Is pshia, and therefore leaving the kelim after an accident is a chiyuv, then the second guy's kelim should also be chayiv. Init kalav poshehu, if you're more forgiving, you're from the Rabbi Yehuda and Rabbanon liberal party, and you say the person that bumped is not poshea, and his kelim left behind are okay, are forgivable, and because it's really after past accident, afilu ishanam li patel, let the first guy also be potu. What's its discrimination between between the first guy's kelim and the second guy's kelim? That's the question of the Gemara. Yeah? Answers the Gemara, no, with base. And the answer is like this. We all feel that there is a reason to discriminate. Who's the first guy who caused this entire business, generally speaking? Not generally. Even though he not be Me'achuz Poshea, the first guy is the father of all evils over here. In a crash accident, imagine yourself nowadays a person driving down Kvish Echad, and he has to know what his friend ate for supper last night. It's a chiyuv. Shivisi ha'ayfon lenegdi tomid. So he has to look at the social media to see what his friend ate last night. Very, very choshev information. How can you live without it 1 second? And he has to do it in the middle of the busy road, yeah, while driving. He's texting and he's saying, oh, such a cute, carrot salad. Then what? And he bumped into something. And then the second guy bumped and the third guy bumped. Who's the first one at fault? Of course, the first one is more at fault than the other ones. He's the one who started it. Now, I'm not completely answering the Gemara's question yet, but now the Gemara answers. Says the Gemara, Rishon Vadai Poshehu. The Rishon is for sure Poshea. You know why? There are two levels of Tekolo. That's the Chiddush of the Gemara now. The first guy is a Poshea because he did not bump into anybody else's property. He bumped into something that was already there. In other words, nobody else to blame him beyond him, beyond himself. The first item wasn't belonging to a specific person who put it right there and then. It was something, I don't know, a bump in the road, a tree, something. So the first one, his level of tekolo is worse than the second guy. Therefore, Rishon Vade Poshehu, the first guy is a Poshea. Therefore what? Although we like to say that an accident that resulted afterwards with broken kelim of Hefker is Potur, here is Chayev. The first one is Nitkal Chayev Poshea. His level of Tekolo is Pshia. Yeah, and therefore what? We say, because he is not, he should have been more careful. He's the one leading the entire caravan over here. He should have been more careful. There are cars behind him or people behind him. Because he's a Poshea, that's it. He's chayav for not getting up, that's for sure. And also his kelim, he should have picked up. When do we forgive a person who doesn't pick up his kelim? If it's after an accident, which is not his fault. But this guy, the first one, is his fault. So nothing is forgivable by him. Therefore, the kelim that he didn't pick up on time are not the result of an accident. The result of pshia. Kelim that are on the floor is the result of pshia. We never forgave that. Not Lefi Rabbi Yochanan, if you remember the previous sugya. Sheni, the second guy is not Nitkal Poshea. The second guy, again, was surprised, so to speak, by this fresh accident of the first guy. And the first guy didn't warn him. And the first guy is a piece of, excuse me, I don't want to say what, garbage. He's not warning. He's being disrespectful, as you say, Jeffrey. Therefore, the Sheni is not called Nitkal Poshea. Now, Agufa Mechayev, Dehavelo Lamod Veloy Omad, on the goof that he overstayed his welcome, of course he's Chayev. He should have stood and he didn't, the second guy. The second guy's body is Chayev. Why didn't you stand up? Were you traumatized? How long does it take you to lick your wounds and pick up your objects? Half an hour? Are you insane? Yeah? And don't tell me it's a result of accident. Result of accident only works if you're mafkir your objects because they're worthless. Are you mafkir yourself? Really? Huh? You want me to take you home and be my slave? That would be great. I'll have a free ozer. It's 24/7. You're not mafkir yourself, mister, right? And therefore, in case you bumped into something, and even accidentally, and we forgive you for the bumping, but you sit there too long, you chayv on what? On your body, but amamoinoi potu, but in his objects is potu. The Omer lay, because he can tell the third guy, hai biro lav ano kirise, I did not create, I did not dig this pit, which means it doesn't sound like you're 5 years old, I hope. He says, it's his fault. It's the first guy's fault. He started this whole bow. He started this whole crash chain accident was started by the first one. Let's repeat, and it's actually very easy. If you know the concepts, Rava's statement is a very easy one. Again, the first guy, yes, is more at fault. Yes, we don't discriminate. It's a different reality. The first guy bumped in a way that was more, should have been more careful. He should have been more aware for many reasons. There's nobody else to blame. He's the one who started the whole big balagan here. And therefore, once it's your fault, nothing else is forgiven. You, the kelim, or your grandmother, whoever is next to you, or a little puppy who died, I don't care who. It's all chayiv. The second guy will say, hey, wait, the second guy is less at fault. The actual bumping is not his fault. He's nitka Mishkal Lav Poshea, because the other one is the actual one who started this whole Mahalach, this whole story of the chain reaction started by the first one. He's the catalyst and not the second one. And therefore, the second one, what do we say? Mitzad bumping and colliding, Nitkal Lav Poshea. So therefore, his dishes is potu. It's a very nice point to Jeffrey. The dishes of the second one are the only ones potter out of all four items here. The goof of everyone is chayiv. The dishes of the second one is potter. Why? Because we have a formula. Dishes that are broken, spilled water, garbage, mess, that came after a justifiable accident, potu. Now, on his body is not potu. It was an accident, but he had enough time to get up. And you're not mafkir yourself, you belong to yourself. And therefore you're chayiv. Isn't life beautiful? Very easy to understand, Rava. I prefer no questions until we get to the next Malach. Let it sink. Yeah, I mean, the Pasha, Pshat again. Yeah. Meisivi. Times it more with a challenge, and then you can ask your questions. Rava has a very nice, this is a very nice Pshat in Rava, but there is a problem. A Brice against Rava, oy vavoy. A Brice against Rava, not nice. Meisivi. Kulan chayovin and Lizki Gufan. All of them, 1, 2, 3, Reuven, Shimon, and Yehuda. All of them are chayv on the nozokim caused by their body. Uptuin on Lizkem Aminon. And all of them are potur on nezek caused by their money, by their broken dishes. All of them. My love of Ilurishon. Even the first one on his dishes, damage caused by his dishes is potu. No, that's against Rove. Right, Rava said what? The first one is chayv both on damage caused by him or caused by his dishes. The Rasha says no, that all of them are the same, completely egalitarian. We're egalitarian here. All of them, first, second, third, fourth, I don't know, million, they're only chayv on nezokim caused by the body, and the potter on nezokim caused by the money. The chayv by the body, yeah, and potter by the money. Even the first one, it's against all of it. Rava said that the first guy is a super nitkal, is an uber nitkal, uber posh. Arch enemy, the worst one. So we see what the Brice and Atlak Rova says. Gemara, lo, lebal mirishon. No, everyone except for the first one. Says it doesn't make sense. But kulam ktani. It says all of them, not except for the first one. Maybe everybody means everyone except for the one. It means all those damaged. The first one was not damaged. The first one is the one that, by the way, was not damaged, right? He's the one who sits there nicely sipping his coffee and everybody else is bumping into him and then the other one leaves behind, yeah? He wasn't damaged. All those that were damaged, second, third, fourth, five, six, seven, eight, all of them, they are nizokin and they are chayev on the body and potur on the dishes, their dishes causing damage. And that's exactly like Rava. Says Gemara, hi, Mai, what's your story? What does that mean? Hi, Mai. If you say even the first one is the same and is potu on his kelim, not like Rove, that makes sense to say all of them, which means all of them, including the first one. That's why I say all of them. If you want to say that the first one is different to all the rest, because Rova, you are right, and the first one is a super, super mazik, uber mazik, and therefore the first one is chayv on everything, he is the worst one, my kulan. Why does it say all of them? Lifnei nizokin. The Rashi, as we say in language, the Rashi should have spoken normal, speak normal. The Rashi should have said, the damaged ones, the damaged. Why is the Rashi misleading me and says everybody when it does mean everybody? I'll tell you, everybody in the room gets a prize for a Shoshana, I don't know, a bottle of wine, and then I'll say, except for one. Why didn't you say it to begin with? Why are you misleading us? Yeah? Okay, I hope I can give you a bottle of wine. I'm not promising. Hello, okay. So, Imela, what do we say? Again, so therefore, let's summarize. Rava's pshat is in danger. Rava wanted to say one simple thing. It's not complicated at all. Rava wanted to say one thing. The first guy is worse than anybody else. The first guy bumping should have been more careful. You know there are people behind you? There are all kinds of things ahead of you. There are bumps in the road. There are broken trees. There are stumps and stuff. You should have really been extra careful. And therefore, if you're not careful and you're the one who caused the whole chain reaction, you are super chayv on the actual bumping. And therefore, you're chayv on both you not getting up, people bumping into your body, and you chayv on people bumping into your kelim, because it's not forgivable what you did. It was not an accident. You chayv on everything. The second guy, is a regular guy that we've seen in the previous sugyas. That's the guy who bumps into the water, into all the cases we had, who we follow the opinion of who? Of Chachomim. And they say, if something was a forgivable accident, nitkal rav pusha, nitkal onus, the guy bumping misken is onus, there's nothing else he could have done. Therefore what? On your body, you're chayiv. Once you get up, you're not mafki your body, you still belong to yourself. Please decompose ASAP and get and clear the road for other cars or other people. Yeah. Mashenkin on your dishes, your potur. Why are you potur in the dishes? We follow the formula that says that, listen to my formula in English, hefker, past an accidental fall, is potur. Hefker, after a fall, I fell and it was... I was out of control. The second the things brech, shach, they fail, I'm mafkir, it can't be mechayev me. Very good. So the first one guy is chayev on everything. The second guy is only chayev on people bumping into him, not bumping into his kelim. Isn't life nice? Well, that would be very nice. Hey, the problem is the Brice is against Rava. The Brice seems to be saying, not like Rava. It's like you have a very nice pshat. There is a Russian tosis against you. That happens all the time in Bismillah. Yeah, all the Rishon, a nice pshat, but it's not true because you're over wrong, L'choira. The Brice says what? That the first guy is chayev on everything, meaning him and his body and his kelim are chayev. And the second, no, excuse me, the Brisa says the other way. The Brisa says both first and second and third and fourth and million, the chayev and nezek caused by their body sitting there over time. And anything caused by their dishes, they're potter, including the first guy's potter on his kelim. Ugh, that's against Rava. Question against Rava. Therefore, now we're going to explain Rava's pshat in a different way. Continue? I can continue. Yeah? Ah, very nice. Pshia. Elo amarove. Therefore, Rava is tweaking his own pshat, and now the word "his" is gonna change meaning. Thank you for the tiyur, Rabbi Yitzchok. Ela amarove, rishon chayev ben benizke gufoi de sheni ben benizke mamoinoi de sheni. We completely switch. Let me now give you the introduction. The word "his" is completely different, which means rishon. You know what the first guy is chayev on? Is chayev for damages caused when somebody bumped into his body of the first one. He's chayev both. Let's say I'm the first guy. I'm sitting there way too long. Yeah, I could have got up already, and I'm playing the martyr, the misken. I'm sitting there for more than I should have, and then a person bumps into me, or his kelim bump into me, and they trip and they fall. Okay. I am chayev for both damages done to his, meaning the damaged guy, the second guy. I'm chayev for what happens to his body, and I'm chayev to what happens to his dishes. Get me? Mashenkin, if I'm the second guy, and the third guy bumped into my body, then we say what? We say, you are chayev only on people bumping to your body if there are people, but your potur, if you bump into what? If the kelim bumped into me, then I'm potter on the kelim. Me, as a sitting person, I'm only chayv on damage done to a person and not done to kelim. And you guys, if you follow the introduction, which I think you did, you can understand very, very nicely why. We're basically changing gears now. What? Very nice. Before we give the whole picture, let's get to the crux of the matter. The first guy sits there and the second guy sits there. They look to me the same, but they're not the same. The first guy, we define his nezek as an odom amazik. Because the first one is, as we say, so to speak, more chayev, he has more liability, he started the trouble, he's the amolek, he's the one who started the issue. Therefore, the first guy is looked at as odom amazik. Odom amazik is chayev on everything, as our esteemed colleague said over here and over here. Odom amazik is chayev on everything. Odom, kelim, grandmother, and blue socks, or whatever you want, red socks. Everything is chayev. The first one is viewed as odom amazik. So if this bumped to him, the person, or kelim bumped to him, no difference. The second guy is, so to speak, less chayev, and we say nitkal rav poshea. The nitkal is not a poshea, right? Therefore, people who bumped into him, it's bechlal chidush that we mechayev him because he's less at fault. Therefore, we mitigate it, Jeffrey, and we say the second guy is less chayev, it's a lesser degree crime, so to speak, and therefore we give him the title, we define him as Bor. And Bor, last time I checked, is only chayav on people hurting and not kelim breaking. And that's what the Bryce, that's what Rav actually meant. Let's read it inside. Elam Rav. Rishon chayav ben benizke gufoi desheni. The Rishon is chayav for nizokim caused to the body of the second guy. Why? Because he's Bor. Ben benizke mamayno desheni. Excuse me, because he's odom amazik. Ben benizke mamayno desheni. And also, if the money, i.e., the dishes of the second guy bumped into the first one, is chayav because he's not Bor. That's part of the kingdom. Is odom amazik. Odom amazik is chayav on everything. Now, what about the dishes? Now, Rava here is very nicely fitting into the brisa. Let's finish Rava, and then we'll see how Rava now is making peace with the brisa. I'm just continuing one more line. V'sheni, what about the second one? Chayev benizke shlishi benizke gufoi. The second one is chayev for damage caused to the body of the third guy. If the third guy bumped into the second one, is chayev because he is a bor. Avaloi benizke mamaynoi, maitame davele bor. Because the second one is only a bor, second degree crime, so to speak. Mimela, if the second guy's kelim bumped into him, is potur because he's bor. Velo metzina bor shechia bor is a kelim. We never in our lives ever found bor chayev bekelim, except for a buta, leave a buta alone, okay? So we made it very good. Let's summarize now. Rava did brilliant job by maintaining his pshat and keeping at peace with the Braisa. What did the Braisa say? The Braisa said, both of them are chayav in the guf and potter in the kelim. Says Rava, you know what? Very nice. I agree with the Braisa. I'm just tweaking my pshat. I'm reinterpreting my pshat. And a chinami. The kelim of the first and the second one are potter. Why? Because nitka lav poshea. Right? The first and the second kelim are potter. They came after an accident. True, they came after an accident. Yofi. Post-accident kelim, mafkir. We have this formula in our minds. Post-accident hefker, potter. What about the person himself? Chayev. A person who overstayed his welcome after an accident is always chayev. And says Rav, I agree with the Braisa. True, Mrs. Braisa. Nachon. The first, both first and second are chayev if people bumped into their body. 100%. But the question is how much? I, Rav da Amoira, have every right in the world to insert my scale of different degrees into the Braisa. And I say, true Braisa, I agree with you, Braisa. I'm not a koifer. I agree that both first and second are chayev if people bumped into the sitting body. However, how much and who? The first one is looked at like an odom amazik, mimele kelim who broke into him are chayev, is odom amazik, because he's worse. The second one is always looked at more in a more forgiving eye, and therefore the second one is what? Is Bor. Bor is potter and kelim. Very nice. However, questions? No, yes. So look at Rashi. No, Rashi says like this. Says, oh, Shen is not a Pasha, yeah. Rishon gufo mazik. The first one is worse. The first one is the one who should be more careful, maybe because people behind him. Whatever the case is, I admit I don't 100%. I didn't see the Rishonim a very clear Agdara, but we said that the first one is one who at the end of the day caused more trouble. He's Batsam, the initiator of this whole mega ball here. Frag the Gemara, this could be very nice. Rav's pshat could be very nice pshat, but there's a problem. We basically want to say here that a person can be a bo. The second guy is a human bo. He's a guy who's alive and kicking in a very big Talmud Chacham, a big professor in university. I don't know, he's a very big man, but lavdil. But what? But he's a bo. Frag the Gemara, it's not so simple to say a person can be a bo. Why? Frag the Gemara, line starts with the word bo, a few lines above the Mishnah. Hanicha l'Shmuel, remember the Machlokes Rav Shmuel at the very beginning of the Perek? What did Shmuel say? Bor is, whether you own it or not, it's a bor. Rav said, only if you're mafkir, the other way from, yeah. But Rav said, only bor which is hefkir, you chayim, but if you still own it, if you own the puddle of water, if you own something, it's not bor. It's something else, shor, odom, ah. Something owned by me cannot be bor, I'll be chayim in it for other reasons, in other ways, maybe chayim even more. Frag the Gemara, we're in trouble. Deep. According to Shmuel Nicha, it's good. Very nice pshat according to Shmuel, says the Mishnah Torah. Kol tekolo is bo. Any tekolo can be bo, regardless of the ownership. But according to Rav, you are in trouble. The Omer I afkir in iloi iloi. Rav said, if you mafkir your object, it's bo. If you're not mafkir, it's not bo. It could be even worse. Michael Amema, are you mafkir yourself? Can a person be mafkir yourself? No. You own yourself. If you own yourself, mimela, how can it be a bo? A person just can't be bo, halachically. Why? Because according to Rav, bo is something, an object which I disown, which I relinquish my authority over. That cannot be my own body. It's me. There's no such thing as mafkir me. Sounds like some nice philosophical idea. Shtriot, yeah? Lo'ilam, therefore, we go back to square one. Kedomah mikore. Ha-ha. We go back to pshat one. It's not complicated. That's it. That's the end of the story. Really, what do we say? We say like the first pshat. What was the first pshat in Rove? Let's repeat and let's review. Rove said as follows. The first guy falling, he himself is chayev if things bump into him, right? And his kalim also. His kalim, if people bump into his kalim, is chayev because he's nitkal poshea. His tekolo is pshia. So anything that happened past that is also a result of that, you're chayev, mafkir or not. The second guy has a special prerogative, is less chayev on the bumping, on the colliding. Mimelo himself is chayev for staying over time, but on his kelim is patu, because that's what we call past accident hefker. Remember the rule, past accident hefker potur, on hefker, like the kelim. I, v'dikashelach kulan chayovin, I, the Braisa, excuse me, Rova, the Braisa said, all of them are chayev, Rishon, Sheni, Shlishi, Ravi, Koyen, Levi, Shlishi, Ravi, Chamishi, Maftir, all of them are chayovin, on what? On their body. Now, we said all of them are chayev on their body and potter on the kelim, right? And you say they're all chayev on one end, on body, and all of them potter on the kelim. How does that make sense, right? It's not like Rova. Tirgam Avada Bar Manyumi, don't worry about it. Tirgam Avada Bar Manyumi Kamed Avina Shehuzku Kalim Be Kalim. Very, very nice. He said like this. There is one common denominator, I don't know if you noticed it, in Rav's first shot, there is one common thing by Kalim Be Kalim. Yeah? Kalim Be Kalim, we said like this. We say, the moment you're potter, nachon? However, what happens if the first guy, his kli is in the street? Is he chayv if something bumps into his kli? The first guy, it's a bit of a test now. The first guy fell, he's a big criminal over here. He should have known better. He fell, everybody bumps into him, he's chayv. Now, his kalim, people bump into his kalim and hurt their toes and they fall over, is chayev. What about other people's dishes that bumped into his dishes? Chayev or potter? Potter. Why? Kalim, because bo became him. If I put my kli in the street, which is bo, and somebody else has come with his kalim on the way to the mikveh and bumps into them, in the mikveh there's a lot of kalim around, potter, because bo became him potter. Ah, one second. Now, the second guy, what about the second guy's kalim? They're potter from everything because he's post-accident hefker. Ah, voila! We found a common denominator. Very nice. We found a common denominator. When the Raisa said that the kalim of both of them are potter, it's true. It's true that I, Rova, said that the first guy's kalim are chayev and the second guy's kalim are potter. But there's still one cute common denominator. Both first guy and second guy, if kalim bumped into them, they're potter for two different reasons. The first guy, because it's bo and kalim bo are potter. The second guy is potter because he's completely potter on everything, because that's post-accident fall, hefker. Very good. Mimela Rova survives beautifully. Jeff, aren't you happy together with me? The first, yes, yes. Yes, Rova, I stand by what I say. Listen again. Rova sticks to his guns and Rova is the winner. Give me R, give me A, give me V. Rova. Rava sticks to his guns, and he says like this. I'll summarize and review and repeat again and again. Says Rava like this. Two people, that's a maskono. That's the final truth. We found the light. Yeah? First guy walks down the street with a heiliger smartphone, and he has to know what Prince, she has to know what Prince Abela told Yachna Bela yesterday. How can you live without it half a second? And she bumped into something, looking in the smartphone. Pasha, nachon? So she fell, or he fell, and the kelim fell, yofi. Chayev on everything. What's everything? Chayev both on his body, if anybody bumps into him, and chayev, his kelim are bor, but Mr. Bell, the bor is anyway potter on kelim. When we say chayev on everything, which means his body is what is Adam HaMazik sitting, and his kelim are bor. But bor, even the worst scenario, is always potter on kelim. True? Now comes the second guy, and he bumped into him, and he fell, and he overstays his welcome. They commiserate together. Now the second guy, what about him? The second guy's body is Adam HaMazik, right? Chayv on everything. And his kelim are potter on everything, because Bahim, it was a real honest, innocent accident, and he was mafkir the kelim, and post-accident hefker is potter. So we found one, that's Rava. Says Rava, you're attacking me from a brisa? Because a brisa said that both the first one and second one on potter and kelim, yes, because both the first guy's kelim and the second guy's kelim are potter if kelim bumped into them. Why? The first guy, because he's bow, real bow, and kelim is bow potter, and the second guy's potter, because potter and everything. He's 100% potter, and he's 50% potter, but they do meet in the middle of a concentric circle, and that is what? Both are potter and kelim. He's potter because he's really bow potter and kelim, and the second guy's potter because he's potter and everything, because he's a real miskan accidental shlumazel, that we potter. So Mimela Rav is not size of the Bryce, and the Bryce works very well with Rav. Of course he's chayev, the first guy. The first guy, of course, is chayev. Chayev on persona. He's chayev if person fell into his kelim. He's kelim and chayev if people bumped into them and hurt their toes. Because the bor is chayev on odom patsua, hurt. The first guy's kelim are bo. Bo is chayev on odom, unless he died. He's chayev on odom that injured himself. Potter on kelim. No, potter on kelim, damage done to kelim. His kelim is damager, damaging source of damage, are bow. Bow is chayev on damage caused to a person by it. His kelim are bow.
He's chayev on his kelim.
Depends on what? His own kelim are next to him, yeah. And he from some funny reason refuses to pick them up, and he's a posher. He doesn't have the ptur of post-accident. No, it's a vicious thing what you did. You should have known better, right? So the kelim next to you, lying to you, broken, not broken, by the way, if they're sitting next to you, if they're a bow, therefore, we learned in Kita Hei, that if a person bumps into the bow, then the bow is chayev, and the bow owner is chayev, and if kelim bump into them, then the bow is potter. That's all. He's chayev. The first guy is chayev. Absolutely. Because bow hurting a person is chayev. Shank and kelim, the bumped into kelim, are always potur. Because bow be kelim is potur. I, the brisa doesn't scare me, says Rava. I also agree that there is a certain point of, there's a meeting point. Because the second guy's kelim are also potter and kelim. They're potter and everything, because they're not bor, because of post-accident. But Lamaisa, it's still true. The Rava and the Brisa can coexist very nicely. Such a sweet Talmud, one of the sweetest I've experienced since we started learning Bava Kamma. That's my personal experience. I just want to finish before the Mishnah. There's a beautiful, beautiful Tosfos. Yes.
Rava went backwards.
Yes, to the first shot.
The first one is not bor.
No. The first one is liable on everything, but what does everything mean? His body is chayev on everything. His kelim are chayev as much as bor can be chayev. But a bor is never chayev on kelim. Even the most vicious, I don't say a bad word, the vicious terrorist who dug a bor in the middle of the street, yeah, rosho, and kelim fell inside his potu. That's because there's a kosu. See, you can't be chayev more than that. That's what we're saying. The second guy's kelim are completely potu because it was really an honest mistake, the fall, and I was mafki right away. I'm potu and everything. Very good. That's all we're saying.
So, we
yeah.
Earlier,
okay.
The guy carrying the
theme. Continues. Omar Imach mesrishon noflu, rishon chayev nizkei. Kulam. Let's say all of them fell because of the first one. It was not a classical, they're not in a vertical line. How do you call that? Yeah, like they're not one behind the other, right? But let's say all of them were nitkal in the first guy. Then only the first guy is chayv, not anybody else. Zog de Gemara, heichi nafil, how exactly did the first guy fall? You blame everyone on him. Of Pope Omar, the Pascal Uche Kishilda. He actually lied there on the floor. He lied horizontally across the street completely, blocking the entire street. What? He blocked completely like a shielda, like a nevela. He was lying there, says shielda, like or shelid, but the Rashi says nevela. Basically, he's lying there like a dead animal. Imagine yourself a big cow, boom, blocking the whole thing, and they all bump into him. Rav Zvid amar kichuto de semyuta. Rav Zvid says like a blind person stick, like a cane of a blind person, which sometimes goes vertically. The blind people many times, right? They walk, they do back and forth like in, not vertical, I meant diagonal, diagonally. He's lying in the street diagonally. What's the difference? There is a difference. The first case, everybody can see him, the first and the second and the third, they can all see more or less the same, right? Imagine yourself a road with three lanes, yeah? And there's a truck stuck in the middle, okay? Big truck. If the truck is mamish, properly horizontal, all three cars in all three lanes can see it the same. Right? So the first, it's all his fault. What about if the truck, the lorry, it's a lorry. Yeah, the lorry is really diagonal. So to one lane, it's very close. But if you drive on the other faraway lane, you can't see the truck yet. Yeah, so even if you see an accident on the first lane, you don't know that soon you'll meet an accident on your lane, which is much further. You get me? Because the truck is that way further from you. So that's the chiddush. Look at Tosfos here. Kichuto de samyuta, a Rav Papa polig. Rav Zvid argues on Rav Papa. The Tosfos starts chuto de samyusa. Mesvil Rav Zvid, the chipaskel ucha kishilda, lo yorishin chabinizke shlishi, shalli lizok shor sheni shenofal. Wow. Says Rav Zvid like this. If the truck is actually ahead of you, and you see the first guy that fell already, don't you think? Don't you realize, hey, the first guy fell. Why did he fall? Stop. You see somebody in the road, some kind of accident, you should slow down, or at least slow down. You see something. Aval bechuta de samyusa. Therefore, the first guy would not be chayav in the third one. Wow. Because the third one should have been more careful. He should have seen the telltale signs. Don't you see what's happening already? First accident. Aval bechuta de samyusa davi ba'alachson. I'm continuing to say, if it's like the blind man's cane, that it's ba'alachson diagonally. Kshenitka larishon b'roish chutra. The first guy bumped in one area. Ocho shba'achakach minitka b'sofu chutra lo'y ro'oh. Didn't see him. Imagine such a very big road, like in more advanced countries, I don't know, in Canada, in America, in Germany, there are many lanes. Yeah, you don't even see what happens in the first lane. I drive one lane quickly, fast. I don't see what's happening in the first lane. So could be here also, it didn't seem. The chuta, yeah, if this is the truck over here diagonally, the guy who bumps into him here and fell, the guy who comes over here doesn't see anything. He doesn't see what's happening on the other side of the street. And he doesn't see anything heavy here either. The whole thing is happening much later. Then the first guy is chayev, because the third guy had no way to know. Wow. Ooh. Now, I want to share with you an unbelievable Tosfos. Tosfos, a few amudim ago, and that's thanks to Oiz Vahodo, the Oiz director of the Tosfos team. Do you realize there's a very big irony over here? Not the irony you're asking, Jeff, but something else. You see that the second guy, what do we say about the second guy? We say that the second guy is innocent regarding the first guy. The first guy, let's leave all the details alone. Even if you didn't get all the details, and today you're going to review it online, right? You're going to go to the website and review if you want. Leaving everything else aside, is the second guy culpable or not? Is the second guy responsible or not? There isn't a contradiction here in the whole sugya. I'll tell you why. The second guy can tell the first guy, hey, I bumped into you. You chayv on my kalim. Yeah, you on your body. You chayv on my body. You're the mazik. And I'm an innocent guy. I'm not expected to see where I'm going, right? As we said many times, a guy who digs a bore in the street cannot say, I dig a bore in the street, and everyone else should watch their step. That's called what? Egocentric? Narcissist? I don't know what it's called. It's some people live like that. They're the only ones in the world. Everybody else should adjust themselves to Mr. Ego. Everyone, yeah, I think before, we tell this guy, now look at that. The second guy on the other end was blaming and screaming on the first guy and will get his money from him. Now the third guy bumps into the second one and the third guy claims from the second one. Now we'll say, excuse me, we just said that the second guy, it's not his fault for bumping. You said that the first guy cannot say to the second one, it's your fault. Mashma, the second one is innocent. And say, oh, Miss Ken, he fell, he didn't know. It's your fault, Mr. First Guy. If you say, Miss Ken, the second guy didn't know, how come he's chayv to pay for this nezek of his body on the third one? Easy, a very easy answer. We get the question? Is Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde? And when the second guy approaches the first one, we say, oh, poor second guy, he bumped into the big criminal, the first one. But when the third guy hit the second one, we tell to the second guy, oh, second guy, you should have paid. Yeah, what's going on? Very easy. Yes, he wears two hats. When you are wearing the hat of the one being damaged, then you are the underdog. Then we say, the first guy who damaged cannot be Mr. Ego and say, I'm damaging, everybody else should be careful. But the second one, the second one clapping the first one, when he's the tovea, the one being hurt, he can say, I was hurt. I'm not expected to look at you and watch my step. You're supposed not to get an accident. The second guy clapping, the third one would say, it's your fault. Why? You, Mr. Second Guy, Lemaisa, if you cause damage to others, now you're wearing the hat of the damager, the one causing damage, and there you have responsibility. No stira. When you're the one being damaged, we are with you, and we say, you can't, yeah, Lemaisa, it's the same logic again and again. The one damaging should always take responsibility. The one being damaged, his responsibility is off his shoulder. Sometimes it's the same guy in both. Sometimes Mr. Second Guy is both damager and damagee. As one damaging others, he has responsibility. As one being damaged, he doesn't. That's the way it is. He has two different court cases, two different files, two different stories in the police, in the real police. In Mela, that's what we say. From here, says Taisfas, we learn a yesoid, that a person should always be more careful not to hurt others than not to hurt himself. I don't have that much responsibility to look after myself. That's my own problem. But not to hurt others, I have more responsibility. The other way from what many people think. Tomorrow, Meretz Hashem, we'll start the Mishnah. And then I'll hear your questions about the Mishnah. I recommend you see this year again, watch it again, live, or online, and then you'll get me the questions. Have a good day.